Next, we're going to investigate how the input force affects the motion of the mass, or the output of the system. The most two fundamental inputs are step and sinusoidal. All the input can be treated as the combination of these two. In this video, we're going to examine when the force input is a step signal, which is a constant over time. The mass is 10 kg and the spring constant is 100 newton per meter as before. The damping coefficient is said to be 5 newton second per meter now. So the system is underdamped according to our previous calculation. We learned in class that the input force changes the right-hand side of the equation of motion from 0 to F, which is the input force. Therefore, it will affect our steady-state solution. If you're not familiar with how to calculate steady-state solution, please review it first. When input is a step signal, the steady-state solution in the S domain is calculated by this equation. The steady-state solution equals to the transfer function times the right-hand side of gain and evaluated as S equal to 0. That is F over K in our system. It is the same solution in the time domain, so if our input force is 100 newton, our steady-state solution should be F over K equals to 1. Let's see if it is true. First, let's quickly review what it looks like when there's no input force. Set the input force to be 0 and run. Now, since our damping coefficient is really small, it will take a little bit long time to get to a steady state. So after about 20 seconds, the system almost gets to a steady state. So now we'll keep this on mind. And now we're going to change the input force to 100 newton. Now the system is having some damped oscillation as before. Again, it will take a little while to come to a steady state. Okay, so now the system is coming to a steady state. There's no oscillation at all. So if you compare these two figures, one without input force, one with input force, the shape of the oscillation did not change. This is because the decrease of amplitude in each cycle is determined by the damping ratio. The period is also kept the same. As you have learned, the damped frequency is a function of spring, mass, and damper. Both damping ratio and damped frequency are determined by the system parameters and therefore will not be changed by input signal. Now we take a look at the steady state solution. When the system has no input force, the mass came to stop at a position around -16.7. And after adding some input force, the mass stopped at -15.7, which is 1 meter right of the case without input force. And it matches our calculation. This proves that the input force alters the steady state solution. Now you may wonder if the effect of the input force to the system will be the same if our system is overdamped. So let's go ahead and change the damping coefficient to 90. So now it reached to a steady state, no oscillation. If we compare this with the one without any input force, even with one tilted down and one tilted up, which is determined by its starting position, we can see that the shapes of both motions are the same. This again proves the motion is determined by the system parameters, which means the spring, mass, and damper, but not by input. And if we check the steady state solution, the one with force is again 1 meter to the right compared to the one without any force. In conclusion, when there is a constant input force, the steady state solution will change according to the equation, but it does not affect the motion. In your own simulation, you can alter both the input force and spring constant and see if the result matches your calculation.